Hello, everyone. My guest today is Guillaume Moubeche. He's the CEO and co-founder of a company called Lemlist. He's a SaaS lover with a passion for growth hacking. Since starting the company, he's traveled the world for a year using social networks to stay at locals and local spots for free. He has two master's degrees in chemical engineering and marketing and is now all in on the company. Guillaume, are you ready to take us to the top?
Yes.
All right. What does Lemlist do and how do you make money?
So Lemlist is a software as a service. So it's the first email automation platform that can generate personalized images directly into cold emails.
Okay, so personal images into cold emails. Tell me what that means. Is this like merge tags for images?
Yes, so you can insert merge tags within images or dynamic images such as logos, people faces, or whatever you want actually. As long as you have an URL or something you can upload, you can insert and create personalized images.
Got it. So like if there's a meme of Beyonce that I want to send out to everyone, I can say, you know, hey, you know, bracket, bracket, first name, bracket, bracket, this is you last Sunday night or something like that.
Absolutely. That's something you could do.
You're Beyonce every night, right?
Yeah.
All right. Tell me more about the company. So you said it's a SaaS play. What do people pay you on average per month?
It's around like $40.
Okay. $40 per user. And then give me more of the story here. So you traveled the world. I mean, when did you start the company officially?
We started like the first line of codes mid-November in 2017, launched in beta beginning of January this year, and officially launched on AppSumo like a few weeks ago.
Okay. And what are you at today in terms of total paying customers?
So we had more than 3,000 customers paying on AppSumo, and we have a total of 4,000 users today.
What about, so I know AppSumo, it's a one-time for life. Tell me about just your monthly recurring. How many just monthly recurring?
We're just starting right now. So
okay, so like less than 10.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay,
yeah.
Good. So how do you start, I mean, AppSumo can be really valuable or it can be really bad because you basically have to support these people for life. So like how did you strategically think about doing it, and how do you move all these customers and eyeballs AppSumo has driven you? How do you change these people over to a monthly plan so you can get more value?
Okay, so there is a few type of people in AppSumo. You have a great part that is buying stuff because of fear of missing out. So those people actually buy coupons, maybe log in once, and would never use actually the product. Then you have all the person that are giving really great feedback. And this is the one we actually like are talking to. So companies who, for example, who have VC funding or these kind of things. And then, you know, like it's all about the active users. At the moment, we don't really have like a really high server load. So for example, our server's load is still the same. So we still get like really high margin, you know, since it's software. And that's pretty much, yeah, what we're at right now.
Mm-hmm. And tell me more about the team. What's the team size?
We're just like three people. So three co-founders. So like two guys working on the head, and I'm doing business marketing growth.
Okay. And how did you?
the
equity conversation is always a tough one. Did you guys just split it a third, a third, a third?
Absolutely.
Literally 33, 33, 33.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay. Yeah. Why'd you make that decision?
You know, like for us, it's we're thinking about like building like a really cool business, and we want, you know, to have equal share, be equally motivated for the entire project. We all have different and complementary skills. So we think like all skills are equal. We need the tech part, we need the commercial and like business part. So it's pretty much, yeah.
Makes good sense. Now, how are you supporting your guys' self right now? Obviously it's not really making that much money today. How are you paying yourselves?
We're not. So that's why we actually have to start growing the MRR. So we have a little bit of savings, and you know, like our goal is to get like salary just to live and, as of maybe like October 2018.
Yep. What are your current, because you're based in, are you based in France?
We're based in Paris. So
Paris.
I'm
envious. It's beautiful there. So you're based in Paris. What have you been able to minimize your living expenses to per month?
I live at my girlfriend's house, so I'm not paying rent, which is great. And I don't know, around like 500 euros. I eat a lot of pastas.
I was going to say, so good. You figured a way to hack rent, you know, get a girlfriend. You figured out a way to keep your food really low. What, no other expenses? You walk to work, no cars, gas, nothing like that?
No. And we also have like French is it's a wonderful country because we have some subvention from states. So I actually spend maybe like 500 euros per month and the States is giving me like 450. So it's, yeah.
What do you mean? The country gives you?
The country gives money, you know, for entrepreneurs that are launching businesses and
doesn't
have salary. Yeah. It's so cool.
So how do you go from successful AppSumo launch? You get a chunk of cash. You have all these users. You guys are probably all in the support emails all day long for the past couple of weeks. How do you now shift focus to like getting your first 100 monthly paying customers? Where are they going to come from?
Okay, so like the acquisition channel are obviously cold emailing because we use our own platform. It's very cheap. You know, like scrapping emails nowadays is like super easy, and sending emails to people is kind of our specialty. So we have actually like a really high reply rate whenever we start launching campaigns. And also like definitely use a referral and affiliate program. So use our customer base to bring users and give them some revenue shares based on the users they bring us.
Mm-hmm. And how do you convince them to market your tool versus all the other, you know, tools out there that do this kind of thing?
It's actually really interesting because basically like our differentiation with the images is actually like super powerful. And every time someone use Lemlist, they realize that they increase their reply rate. We had like companies such as Freshdesk.
Yep.
Like who have been, they have been like A-B testing like images versus no images. And they realize that they get like higher reply rates whenever they were using like personalized images. So, you know, like with all these type of reviews, like right now we have around like, 120 reviews on Captera, and lots of people are actually, you know, like...
How did you get all those reviews on Captera?
Well, actually, they got in touch with us and they say, hey, guys, do you have users that would like to give a review? So we send a list and then, you know, they take care of everything. You send the list to Captera and then the Captera take care of asking them, hey, guys, would you like to give a review?
Got it. And how big was your list? How many did you send?
We first sent out a list of 1,000 customers. And now they ask us for more because, you know, they say, hey, everything is working well. Like they have a super high reply rate. Like I think like maybe it's not yet defined, but more than 15% converted whenever they got asked for a review, more than 15% gave it. So.
Mm-hmm. That's great. So you don't have a problem kind of sending them all your email list for them to then get the reviews going because then you rank higher.
Yeah, exactly.
And those are just the AppSumo people?
AppSumo and also Product Hunt. So we launched on Product Hunt in January and we had like quite a peak of users, but we were in beta at that time. And quite a lot of people actually started using Lemlist in beta and are
How
really
many
happy.
From Product Hunt?
350.
Okay, it's pretty good. How many upvotes did you get?
880.
Oh, that's pretty healthy. How did you get that many upvotes just launching from scratch?
Basically, like I guess people liked the idea of having like personalized images, and also like you know, we're based. I'm just gonna show you around. Station F. So it's like it's built by Xavier Niel, who is basically a big owner of an internet company in Paris, like internet service providers. And it's the biggest campus of startups. So we're actually in the Zendesk incubator and we have
What's it called again?
It's Station F.
Station F, okay.
Yeah. So it's like the biggest campus worldwide in terms of size. And there are like lots of programs such as like Facebook, Microsoft, and so on.
Got it. Okay, so besides affiliates, what other ideas? I mean, what other things are you guys pursuing to drive your first paying monthly customers?
So affiliates, customer cold email, and AdWords. We're gonna try to steal like some competitors.
Who do you see yourself competing with?
So I think Mailshake is a decent competitor. There is also like companies such as Reply. Reply.io, or I don't know, like Prospect HQ or Outreach, for example.
Yep.
It's a well-known one.
And what do you guys want to do with the company, right? I mean, how old are you?
I'm 26.
Okay, 26. Okay, we're actually about the same age. So what do you guys want to do with the company? I mean, is this the create a quick win, make some money, and then go for the billion-dollar home run? Or you think this can be a really big billion-dollar business?
It's very difficult. Like, we're very early. Like, I would say we want to get to grow the company as big as possible. We're not really looking for fundings because that's not really our vision. And we like the way bootstrapping company works because I believe we really focus on users. Then, you know, we find like really market fit and a channel of acquisition that works and that is cheap. And then like we can grow steady, but, you know, like really. And with no kind of VC pressure and all and yep. so on. And yeah, basically like the goal is really like to be different from what every other cold email is doing. Like people were saying for a long time, like don't send images in your cold email. That's not good. That's not professional. It's not true, you know, like we've experienced it. It's working. As long as you be different and you get the attention of your user, you get more replies. That's a fact, and everyone who's using it loves it. So it speaks by itself, basically.
And tell me more about how long this took you to code. So you said you wrote the first line of code, I believe you said November of 2017, right? So it took 2-3 months to code?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. So the entry barrier in terms of like, I mean, my co-founders are really good. Like they're a bit older. They're both like around like 40 years old, and maybe they started coding when they were 5.
So how'd you convince them to join you? Whose idea was it? Who was convincing who?
I actually met them in Station F. Initially, they saw my determination. I think I convinced them because I started working on another project with Russian freelancers. I had to live to Russia and spend like 3 weeks in the middle of nowhere in Russia. And then they show like how motivated I was, you know, like to launch a proper SaaS business. And then in the end, they got convinced and they say, okay, let's do this. So yeah, that's pretty much how.
Have they had an exit? Like, did they all quit like corporate jobs or something to do this?
No, they have actually they also have another project called Talkus. Talkus is basically like a chat integrated in Slack. So people can get in touch with you directly. That's what we're using on our website. So it's a live chat that is integrated in Slack.
That's great. Interesting. Well, listen, I love the story. You're obviously really early and people always go, Nathan, like have some people that are earlier on your show. Don't wait till they're like, you know, 100 million in ARR and they're about to go public. So it's fun to kind of get in your head and understand kind of where you're at, how you're thinking about growth channels. And kind of how you found your co-founders. I think it's a great story. So any other, like today after you hang up with me, what's the first thing you're going to go do?
Talk to other users. I need feedback. And that's pretty much what I'm doing all the time. Like I love discussing with users. I love to understand what they're doing. Also like what Jem doing. So that's the great thing here. I can interview a lot of people, just like make them on Lemlist, try to see how they react, you know, to our onboarding, changing stuff. And much what I do.
I love it. All right, let's wrap up here, Guillaume, with the famous five. Number one, what's your favorite business book?
Favorite business book would be Predictably Irrational by Dan Ariely. I love to understand how people think and behave regarding like pricing and so on.
Number two, is there a CEO you're following or studying?
I like Gary Vee. I know it's maybe basic, but I really like him. You know, it's just do it. I like this mentality and mindsets.
Number two, what's your favorite online tool for building the business?
I really like Station. You know, it's it helps me save like a lot of time.
What
you know,
is it, station.com or what?
I don't know. I can find the link for you. I think it's station.co or something. It was like a most upvoted product of the year on Product Hunt.
Okay, got it.
They're also French connection.
Okay, good. Number four, how many hours of sleep do you get every night?
Between 6 and 8.
That's pretty good. And what's your situation? Married, single, you have kiddos?
Girlfriend.
Girlfriend, no kids. None that you know of, right?
Yeah, exactly.
All right. Last question. Take us back 6 years. What do you wish your 20-year-old self knew?
I would say invest all my money in Bitcoin, as many people here.
All right, guys. There you have it from Guillaume. Again, launched Lemless, got co-founders there at his office location there, which is, I believe, I think he said called Station F in France. Met his co-founders, three of them. Wrote the first line of code several months ago. Now that they've launched, they did a big successful launch on AppSumo, did about 130 grand in revenue there, one-time revenue. He's now transitioning and going and saying, how can we get full real monthly recurring revenue here to start stacking a stream of revenue? Going to look at affiliate deals, going to look at cold traffic, cold emailing, going to look at AdWords as well. Guillaume, we're wishing you the best and thanks for taking us to the top.
Thanks a lot, Nathan.